Syria, our region. Okay, you know that these are the three vertices of the prism, P, Q, R. Okay, and here a ray is coming from the source and it is striking the prism at the point M. Okay, after traveling in the prism, the light ray is striking the other end of the prism at the point N and it is coming out. Okay, and this ray, I told it as incident ray, isn't it? The angle made by the normal with the incident ray is called as incident angle, right? And this is the emergent ray. I told you the angle made by the normal with the emergent ray is called as emergent, angle of emergence. And I indicated angle of incidence as I1 and angle of emergence as I2. Okay? Okay, children. When these two normals are meeting at a point and the angle there is theta. Okay? And here, if this is the incident angle, the ray here is the ray is here going like this. So that here the refracted angle here will be R1. You know that, see here, this is the incident ray. And here, inside the prism, here it is refracting. So this will be the refracted. If this is the normal, this angle will be the incident angle and this angle will be the refracted angle. So I wrote R1 here. And here at this place you can take it as a incident angle because it is the incident angle on the other surface. So here it is coming out. So this is actually, you call it as emergent angle. Here the incident angle is R2, right? That has taken it as R2. Okay. Now I extended this incident ray backside and even this extended ray, this emergent ray also backside. They are meeting, they are intersecting at a point and this angle, I took it as an angle of deviation, D. Okay, children? So, see the diagram carefully. What are the total angles we are drawing here? See here, this is the prism and this is the incident ray and this is the normal. It is traveling in the prism, traveling in the prism. It is coming out here and here also I A angle. Here, this is the incident angle, so this angle is called as angle of incident. If this place, if it is the angle of incident, here it is going like this, so this will be the angle of refraction or one. Here, again this is incident on this corner. So this is called as angle of incidence here and I am taking it as R2 and it is coming out here. This is called as angle of emergence and I am taking it as I2 value. And by extending that, we are getting angles here, we are getting a triangle and those angles I took as alpha, beta and angle of deviation. Okay, now let us see. In the triangle, M, S, L. It is a triangle, isn't it? See here, MNS triangle, MNS. It is the equilateral triangle. See, look at the triangle, equilateral triangle. In triangle MNS, there are three angles. See here, R1, R2 and here theta. Okay, you know in the equilateral triangle, the sum of the angles is equal to 180 degrees. So, I wrote here, the angle R1 plus angle R2 plus theta is equal to 180 degrees because the sum of the angles is in the triangle is 180. Okay, that is the rule. Okay, so from this formula, see here R1 plus R2, I took the theta this side. So 180 minus then the positive theta, when you are taking transferring that to equal to other side, then it will change into minus theta. So R2 plus R2 is equal to 180 minus theta. I took this as the equation 1. Now, in the quadrilateral P, M, S, N. P, M, S, N. See what is the shape of this P, M, S, and N. This is like a quadrilateral. In this quadrilateral, P, M, S, N, angle A and angle theta are in the degree. So as these two are opposite angles and you know the sum of the opposite angles is 180. So I give this angle A plus this angle theta is equal to 180 degrees. Okay, when I transfer this theta to this side of the equal, then angle A is equal to 180 minus theta. Plus theta becomes minus theta when it is transferred to the other side. Okay, so see here, this is the second equation. From the first and second equation, R1 plus R2 is equal to 180 minus theta. And angle A is equal to 180 minus theta. If A is equal to C, B is equal to C, it is in what angle A is equal to B? Isn't it or not? So R1 plus R2 is equal to A. So by one and two equations, R1 plus R2 is equal to A. So now see, triangle OML. This is the triangle we are talking about now. O, M, N. In this triangle, and B is equal to alpha plus beta. What is the rule here? That is the exterior angle rule. Exterior angle property. What is that exterior angle property? The exterior angle is equal to sum of the opposite interior angles. This is the exterior angle. These three are the interior angles. But what is the rule? The exterior angle is equal to sum of the opposite interior angles. So, D is equal to alpha plus beta. Okay. So, next, according to the drawing, if you see this drawing, see here, I1 is equal to alpha plus R1. Why I1 is equal to alpha plus R1? Because the vertical opposite angles are always equal. See here, this is like this. Okay, isn't it? Here it is. And here these are the two opposite angles. But in this, they made two sections. So, when I am writing this angle let it be A. And this B, C. And this B, B. So, A is equal to angle C plus angle B. Because in the vertical opposite angles are equal. Okay, so I don't angle I is equal to alpha plus R1. In the same way, angle I2 is equal to beta plus R2. From that, I deduce what is alpha and what is beta. How I deduce? I just took this R1 to this side. I1 minus R1. So alpha is equal to I1 minus R1. And beta is equal to this R2 when it comes to this side, plus R2 becomes minus R2. So after getting these two values, alpha and beta, I substituted these two values in this equation. D is equal to alpha plus beta. So D is equal to alpha plus beta. I substituted the values. By solving that, see here, I1 plus I2 minus of R1 plus R2. When you are taking that minus as common, so you are getting R1 plus R2. After that, I got I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. And here you know, see here, R1 plus R2 is equal to A. From first and second equation, in this equation we got that R1 plus R2 is equal to A. So instead of R1 plus R2, I substituted the value A. So from this, I got D is equal to I1 plus I2 minus A. When I am taking that A to this side, D plus, that minus A is becoming plus A. D plus A is equal to I1 plus I2. Indicates if the incident angle is equal to the emergent angle. That is, if I1, if in a case, this is our assumption. If I1 is equal to I2, which is equal to I, then I1 plus I2 both, I am saying this also I, this also I. So, this I plus I. So, I plus I is equal to 2I. So, here, instead of I1 plus I2, I am substituting b plus a is equal to 2y. Okay, then I value is will be, if you get that 2 into y to this side, if you are taking the 2 to this side, you will it will be from the multiplication, it will be in the dividing form. So I is equal to b plus a by 2. In the same way, if r1 is equal to r2 is equal to r, then r1 plus r2 is equal to 2r. So r1 plus r2 is equal to a. Already you know, already we got it here, r1 plus r2 is equal to a. And I am telling you r1 plus r2 is equal to 2r. So 2r is equal to a, that means 2r is equal to a, r is equal to a by 2. In 9th class, already you read about Snell's law. What is that Snell's law? Already we did it. Sine I1 by sine R1 is equal to sine I2 by sine R2 by sine I2. That means sine I by sine R. Nu is equal to sine I by sine R. So I substituted.